What's interesting about a lot of, or maybe all, of the cemeteries in New Orleans anyway, is because this is bayou land, so we're talking swamps, so they have to bury everybody in tombs instead of actually in the ground. Because otherwise it could flood and they could literally rise above the surface, which would be quite creepy. I just said quite creepy. Quite creepy.
Near the Lavaux tomb is a piece of red brick. Undoubtedly a cast-off from spiritual graffiti writers.
Oh, okay, that's what they used to write the symbols. Ding, 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 ding.
Gabriel can...
Well, look at it.
It's a piece of brick.
Thanks. Not done talking to you yet, buddy. Come on back.
The Wright family, too. Several of Gabriel and Grimes' family members are laid to rest here. The tomb is securely shut.
Last time I opened a tomb, it was in scratches and it did not go well.
Could I have a minute of your time?
What you need, boy?
Kind of a quiet job you've got, isn't it?
He's a hand talker.
Yeah, they act up some at the full moon.
Don't joke about that.
Mind if I pick your brain a minute?
Go ahead. These folks ain't in no hurry.
Ain't that the truth? I love the art in this game. It's so fun. It's very bright, yet it's also kind of dark. I know that's completely... makes no sense, but you'll get it as you see more.
What can you tell me about voodoo?
They say it was part of an old...
Oh man, those teeth!
Bought here by slaves.
Well, yeah, that's what voodoo is.
What can you tell me about voodoo?
I don't really care to talk about it. I don't do it none myself.
Yeah, a lot of people don't like talking about it. It's considered bad karma. Bad juju, as they say.
What can you tell me about voodoo?
I don't really...
Okay, he's not going to tell me anything.
What do you know about the voodoo murders?
Ain't it just awful, them finding those bodies with voodoo things around them? I don't think there's any real voodoo going on. Somebody's trying to cover their tracks is all.
What can you tell me about New Orleans?
Seems like everybody want to visit New Orleans at least once in their lives. And they love the cemetery too. I see tourists in here every day of the year.
See, I was a little paranoid to take a cemetery tour. Long story short, I don't really believe in ghosts, per se. But I do realize there are some things that you should not fuck around with. You know what I mean? Taking a cemetery tour, especially at night. True story, we did try to take a tour of a sort of a ghost tour kind of thing, and we paid like $30 each for it. And there was a parade going on that night in the French Quarter, so we missed it. We basically just wasted our money. So that sucked.
Do you have any idea what Gabriel
It's something without heart
means?
No, can't say that I do.
Gabriel Sancor.
Tell me about yourself.
My name is Toussaint Gervais. I'm the watchman here at St. Louis No. 1.
What exactly do you do here?
Oh, I keep the place tidy, cause. But a big part of my job, too, is looking out for the grievers, you know. People come to pay their respects, and they need looking out for. Sometimes they so grief-bound, they don't know what they're doing.
Tell me about yourself.
That's about all there is to say.
Tell me something about St. Louis Cemetery No. 1.
You know why the dead are buried in tombs?
Yeah, I just said this.
The water table's too high. Them coffins would float right out of their graves. dead would go floating right down into the quarry. Of course, if it was Mardi Gras, nobody'd even notice.
In light of certain events that happened in New Orleans, oh, say, 10 years ago? That's kind of a creepy statement. Rather prophetic.
Tell me something about St. Louis Cemetery, number one.
Well, we won't talk about that.
It's a historical place. People buried in here from the Civil War and back further, too. Take a look around, you'll see.
Alright, I think that might be all I'm gonna get as far as questioning him. Maybe I can show him the voodoo murder picture?
Does this mean anything to you?
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, son. Don't be showing that kind of thing to me. I'm an old man. I'm liable to just keel right over on you.
Sorry.
Yeah, he's got a point. Definitely shouldn't be flashing that around to just anybody. Alright, well, we've... Why can't I access my menu? That's weird. We've gotten a few more points. Nice little dance there, Gabriel. Alright, anything else here?
Food, trinkets, and more unsettling things.
Oh, that's Marie Laveau's tomb.
Marie Laveau's tomb. As offerings from believers.
Yeah, as we'll find out, Marie Laveau was, in a very important, name as far as, voodoo history goes.
A marble snake. Now that's cheerful.
And also, this tree is very creepy.
New Orleans is famous.
Nope,
Gabriel doesn't see.
Not what I looked at.
Here and there in the cemetery. It's an imposing marble tomb from the last century.
Hamilton, huh?
This old.
There's probably no one left in the family to maintain it.
This is the tomb of Marie Laveau.
Marie Laveau,
voodoo
queen
of New Orleans. Odd-looking marks adorn the Laveau tomb wall.
Yep, I'm not going to go into much detail because I don't know a lot, but Marie Laveau
is
important.
Above-ground tombs. The high water tip. The name Ross is inscribed on this old tomb.
God damn it, Ross. I guess I might as well look at these other tombs. I looked at Wright already. I guess I... Can I not go over here? No.
This family tomb bears the inscription...
Fuller Mill.
I hope that's to keep people out.
San Luis. Several generations of an old New Orleans family rest here. In relative peace.
Relative peace? What does that mean? Alright, that's enough for now. Even being here in the day kind of gives me the creeps. Man, I'm glad I turned the speed up. Things were moving a little slow there for a while. I said exit. Thank you. Okay, maybe I can go back to the bookshop and tell her to research some stuff? Whoa,
Darcy,
that was quick.
I haul.
Oh boy, party time.
That was awkward. Alright, maybe I can ask her about the Cabis Uncle and stuff like that.
Hey, you want to see something really cool?
That's disgusting. That's really horrible.
I know. Great, isn't it?
God, somebody ought to lock you up.
Chill out, Grace.
Do you know anything about this?
No, sorry.
How about you research it for me, then?
Got a minute, Grace?
What's up?
Do you have messages for me?
Nope.
Could you do some research for me?
Sure. What?
I can't think of anything.
Okay.
Nope.
Do you know what Caprice Encore means?
Hmm. No. Sounds French, though.
Hey, kids.
Bruno, how nice.
Gee, a customer.
Of yours? Hardly.
How's the flower business?
Well, better than the used book business, I see.
Rare books.
That explains why I so rarely see anyone in here. Are you going to sell me that wonderful painting of yours today?
So sorry guys, I actually stepped away from the computer for a moment, and all of a sudden this dude's here. I don't even know what he said. I'll have to look at it in the recording.
How much would you give me for it, Bruno?
Gabriel, don't you dare sell your father's painting.
Well, I guess I don't need the money that badly.
Yes, you do.
From the looks of the shop, I'm sure you will, my boy. And soon.
My gosh. Anyway. Alright, so I think I might need to go and talk to some other people and see if I can figure out what
Don't hurry.
Gabriel some girl means. Cause I'm kinda not sure. She said she didn't know much, so this isn't gonna help me, I don't think. Now.
Hi. Look around all you want.
Okay, thanks. Could I ask you a few questions?
I wouldn't. You should talk to Dr.
Yeah. Alright.
Do you know anything about-
Nope.
Nah, she's not gonna help me. Okay,
I'll be gone now.
So?
Gran seems to know a little bit of French. She's been around for a while. Why don't we ask her? Where is she? Oh yeah, she's out here.
My precious boy.
Can't stay away from you, Gran.
That sounded kind of creepy.
Make yourself at home, son.
Can't stay away from you, Gran.
Does this mean anything to you, Gran?
Sorry, no, Gabriel.
Nope. Okay, how about Cabli some girl?
Can we talk, Gran?
Of course.
Do you have any idea what Cabri sans cœur means?
Something without something, I think. My French is so rusty. I swear my mind is going.
It's okay.
Yeah, I mean, I know it means something without heart. But the problem is it's written in kind of the Creole dialect, so cœur is actually spelled C-O-E-U-R. Not C-O-R. Alright, boy, I don't know what to do here.
Does this mean anything to you, Gran?
I believe-
Yes, you already told me that. Hey, Gran! I stole from a church!
Does this mean anything to you, Gran?
Sorry, no-
How about a brick?
Does this mean-
Alright.
Well, Gran-
Oh!
Enough for that for now. Yep, I warned you guys. A lot of the game is detective work. You just gotta wander around, you just gotta try stuff and ask people about everything. Just love that police thing. Somehow, I gotta get to talk to Mosley.
Hey, nice precinct.
Thanks.
Blah, blah, blah. Hello, Jim Cummings.
Got a second, officer?
What can I do you for?
Do you know what Cabri sans cœur means?
Can't say that I do.
About Detective Mosley.
I told you he's not here.
Come on, you can tell me what the crime scene is.
Look, I know the paper's got everybody stirred up about these killings, but that don't make it public information. Back off.
So this is a new voodoo murder then?
Hey, I didn't say that. You read all about it in the papers tomorrow, I'm sure.
Gotta show something to him, maybe.
Does this mean anything to you?
Nope.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Does this mean anything to you? Yes, sir.
He doesn't want me having that.
No one goes back there until I say so, mister.
Sorry.
What's funny is that the guy who voices the cop here, Jim Cummings, played a detective cop in a cartoon called Bonkers back in the 90s, and it's the same character. Exact same voice, same character.
This is the last.
Alright. What am I gonna do here? I don't know what to do. I guess I could try asking the bartender. As usual, guys, I'm gonna let myself struggle a bit, but I'm trying to not bore you if I get too stuck. So. I'll skip ahead if I'm lost forever. Okay, surely you know this.
Does the phrase "cabri sans corps" mean anything to you?
You know what goes in it?
I don't think it's a drink.
Oh.
Okay, fair enough.
So what has Sam told you about voodoo?
That's about all I can...
Alright, so you're no help. I need to somehow convince this guy to tell me.
Nothing like a good game of chess, huh?
Yeah, well, this isn't a good game. This is...
Oh, well.
Alright.
Does this?
Not.
Does this mean?
Not.
Nope. Okay.
You pack of wood.
I knew you'd miss me, so I came back.
I wish you wouldn't wear that coat outside in June. I could smell you from here.
Seriously.
The history Gabriel's had. Gabriel doesn't. Gabriel pulls down a book on snakes.
Why did it have
snakes
to be snakes?
Snakes are legless reptiles. Some snakes kill their prey with poison, some by constriction. A snake smells by tasting the air with its forked tongue. The smells are passed back to a sense organ in the
Yeah, we learned this in second grade.
Constrictor snakes, however, sense their prey by vibration.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Did you know that medieval legends about dragons and giant worms are actually based on snakes? You know, dragons, devils, sea monsters, well, they've always been associated with snakes.
Grace, get alive.
So, yeah, I definitely looked up in a walkthrough just now, and it seems like there's some things here I missed, so.
Gabriel's had all those books. Gabriel leaves through a German-English dictionary.
Let's see, Mittag means midday noon.
Gabriel.
Spiel means game. Interesting.
Gabriel.
Himmel.
Gabriel.
Dry.
Gabriel.
Possessen means possessed. That's handy to know.
Gabriel.
Drachen means dragon. I wonder if Mosley would know he was being insulted if I called him Drachenbrill.
Gabriel's hat. Gabriel fight. Gabriel. Gabriel's. Gabriel.
There's a book I'm missing here. I don't know where it is.
Gabriel. Gabriel. The old.
Okay. This is what I'm talking about. This game is just frustrating.
Gabriel selects a volume of German poetry that he always found strangely compelling.
Drei Drachen.
Three dragons.
Drei Drachen kriechen in meinen Schlaf.
In my something.
Die Seele wollen sie lebendig zum Fraß.
Feurigen
Atems, gespeltener Zunge, genießen sie jedes Mal.
Don't know that.
That's nice. Kind of creepy, though. Who's the author?
Heinz Ritter.
Ritter,
I'm not sure what it says, but I get the feeling the guy was one sick puppet.
And of course, I get points for it. Why is the game not letting me save? I don't like this. I don't like this at all. The game doesn't seem to be letting me save. I certainly don't want to lose everything. Yeah, I got a problem here. It's not letting me save. No, it's not letting me save. Oh, God. Okay, so I guess I might as well go ahead and cut the recording here then. Because I'm probably going to have to do this all over again. Yeah, sometimes good old games doesn't quite work out all the bugs. Yeah, it should be letting me save, but it's not. I have no idea what's going on. Anyway, thank you everybody for watching. My name is Chronos006, and I'm signing off for now. Take care.